Hello, my name is Paul Garrett from Orbis Software. Today I'd like to show you how you can use TaskCentre together with Microsoft Dynamics NAV and consume the web services that are available from Dynamics NAV. This is the client of Dynamics NAV, and I just want to show you how you first expose specific web services for use by external applications. If you click on Departments and go into administration and into IT administration and open up the lists, you'll see web services is one of the choices, and select that. And here you get a list of the web services that have been exposed for consumption by other applications, where they're authenticated, of course. And if I click new here, I can create a new service. And I've got a choice here. Do I want to expose a code unit or a page? And in this case, I'll expose a page type service. And I'll choose which service I want to expose. And there's a long, long list of different services. And I'll choose customer card. Now I need to give it a name. I haven't got any imagination, so I'll call it customer card. And say, yes, I want to publish that one. I need to remember that name now, because that service name I'm going to use to find this service in a moment, and say OK to that. And that's all I need to do. That service is now available for consumption. Now, if I just show you how you would consume that service is available at this URL. So here you've got the machine name that I want to connect to, that this installation of NAV is on. This bit is a fixed part, so Dynamics NAV and Web Service, WS. The company name, exactly as it appears in NAV. And page, because it's a page, not a code unit. And that service name, customer card, that I just created. If I go back into TaskCentre, and in TaskCentre, I now need to let it know that this service exists. So in System Tools, Execute, I can choose the web service connector. Now I'm going to add a new service into TaskCentre, so I'll just click add, and I call this nav customer card, and I know the URL of this, and I'll just paste that in there, and you see it contains customer card and WSDL, as I showed you in the example earlier, and the company name here. And if I just click OK on that, it then asks me to authenticate against this. So I'll put my Windows authentication in there, and the password. And click OK. And TaskCentre has now gone away and read that service, and it's worked out lots of details about it. We won't go into the details of these, but it's found all these details, and it's also found a set of operations that it can perform on this service. You've got read multiple, is updated, create, etc. And if I just want to test one of those services now, if I click test on the read service, then it's asking me for the customer card number. So if I just go back into NAV now and go into sales and marketing, I'll just go home, customers, and if I look at this first one on the list here, they're in 612 South Sunset Drive, and I'll just take that number and I put that number into TaskCentre, press test, and it's returned some XML. There's a long key that it read back for the data, and here you can see that it's 612 South Sunset Drive is in the XML that it's returned. Now this is just a test service. This isn't something that you need to use. It's just there available to check that the service is functioning correctly. So I'll just close that, say OK to that, and close it. And that's that service now available in TaskCentre for consumption. In a later video, I'll show you how you can consume that service within TaskCentre. Thanks very much for your time.